Hello, everybody. Welcome to episode 44, where we're going to try and fix that pathing problem that showed up last time. So if I have an L piece on the top here, and I spawn a Witling, he just walks off into space. And we actually get a null reference exception, which I think would be good. So let's step into this and see what we are causing. Okay. So this is checking our, I failed here. Next face start. Oh, next face start could be null. Set pathing new face if start equals null on death. Okay, so that's not actually too horrific. I could put this in here. That seems like it's not a bad idea. Next face start, but I also need overlapped as well. Let's make sure with the shift F12 that this only gets called in one place. Ooh, it gets called in two places. Overlapped. So this is our first time we enter a cube. So start pathing new face. Let's rename this to new old. And we'll do a condition here. And we'll make old null by default, so we don't have to modify any other code except for the one that we're interested in. Okay, so this is where next face start. And old is overlapped? That doesn't seem right. Yeah. Yeah, okay. That seems to be correct. So if old is not equal to null, we get the next face start, which is new. Hey, very cool. Let's see if we can. Hey, solid. Whoa. Ah, okay, dying on a cube. That's right. So now if I die here, I shouldn't be able to turn this. Okay, cool. That makes me happy. So this is the thing that's doing it, this on death. But Witling on death. Do I have a current? Target node. So I do have target node. Next core. This feels wrong to me. Something feels weird. I think I'm going too many steps forward. So how do I do this? On Witling enter cube, shift F12. Set can rotate false. So that's lock spin when occupied. So here we're adding this uncheck can rotate pressure plate lock. I think this needs to be pressure plate lock. That's not it. That's just saying always create something that returns false. So I don't believe it's actually that. I think it's set can rotate. Lock spin when occupied. Set can rotate true. I don't think we want to do it this way. I think I want to add something to cube rotator on check can rotate. Now let's make two private member functions. I guess we don't even need the success. We can just remove fail, can't we? So when we exit the cube, we remove fail. And then lock spin when occupied. Witling movement on death. Target node. Get owning face. This is going to be a nice long line. Get owning cube core. Get component cube rotator. And then can rotate minus equals. This isn't going to work. Clock spin when occupied dot fail. Okay, because that is not a static member. Oh, inaccessible. I do believe this would need to be static as well. Yeah. I mean, this doesn't necessarily need to belong to lock spin when occupied. Wow. Hey. Did. Yeah. Oh, that's not what I want. And then did. Oh, hey. Uh-oh. And do we do new here? Okay. Ooh, ooh, what the heck happened there? Cube spirit link cannot rotate. Where should I put this breakpoint? So on death, let's do that. Let's put the breakpoint there. Whoa. Maybe I need to attach it before I hit go? Oh dear. Okay. So I know that this works fine. Oh, it doesn't. New is null. Oh, I'm dumb. Right. Sure. Okay. Oh, geez. So, okay. So I'm telling it to set a new pathing, start pathing a new face. But the new path node is empty. Oh. Where do I call exit? I think I just deleted a lot of stuff that I was that I'm typing again. Let's see. So we're getting the. Oh no. On Witling exit cube, right? That makes sense. Ooh, that way that function doesn't have to be static and weird, and it can be private. Witling exited cube limited spin. Dead. No, why? What is which one? You cube rotator can rotate true. Cube spirit link cannot rotate, but why? Oh, no. Hold on. Do I need to send a message to all cubes that are linked? Let's put a print. Oh, I already have that print, don't I? That's in the cube rotator. Really? No, it's not. Witling movement. Okay. What's a good way to solve this problem? Or understand the problem. That's important. So when a Witling dies on a spirit cube, that spirit cube's can rotate is no longer undoing itself. Cube core. For some debugging purposes, breakpoint, let's attach. There we go. Oop. Ooh. What? What? Oh, there's two places we're on death. If target node equals null. Ah, so it wasn't a new face. So on death, overlapped. Hey. Death node. Sounds very cool. So we'll move that logic into death. On death is actually the name. And I do believe this should make it happy. Okay. Yeah, you should die down there. Okay. Oop. Okay. On Witling exit cube, let's step into here. Hey, happy times. Oh, yeah. Might want to choose a new color for this. Locked. How many spins do I have left? Only 10 spins used so far. Let's make sure this still works. Yep. We should walk under dead end. Okay. Handling begin rotates. I can get rid of this. Oops. Excellent. So it seems like our pathing issues have been solved. Do, 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 do. We've got linked cubes, slippery cubes. That shouldn't be too hard. Okay, so this slippery bit makes me believe that our whittling movement, whittling movement maybe our whittling movement has a delegate for turning. And then when the witling enters a cube, it should ask that cube core But I need to say directly to the witling and my onCubeEnter doesn't take a witling. And that lives in CubeRotator, doesn't it? No. It lives in witling. No. Where does that live? CubeCore. Yes. Witling enter, witling exit. I believe that this is going to need to take call it when, is there a single word for entering and exiting? There we go. Witling cube transition delegate returns nothing, and it takes a witling movement. That should break a lot of stuff. No, I didn't think that would work. Witling movement. Maybe this is not the right way to go about doing it. But I do need that when a witling enters a cube. Do I though? Yes, because the The Witling needs to know if he can turn or not. And if turning happens, then do a bad thing. We're on a slippery cube. We could just... Not sure how much I like this. Overlapped cube on Witling enter cube. So let's make some private functions here. See, I don't want to do this inside of the Witling. I would rather do it inside of slippery. So let's just think about what that would look like. So in slippery, we know we need the cube core component that's attached to this cube. On Witling enter cube, we want to tell the entering Witling to die if it turns at all. But here we would need a reference to, cube core. I don't know if this will work. I'm pretty sure this won't work. We might need to make an argument. Let's try this out. The solution I'm thinking of only has one, it would only work for one Witling at a time. If we had a whole bunch on the screen, Witling enters the new cube core. We need to talk to that Witling. Yeah. So I believe my original plan was right. Where's my core? Mm. And I'm just going to get rid of this for now. Plus equals. Can I just do this? Huh. Oh. I was really excited about that. Local parameter name test cannot be declared in the scope because that name is used in an enclosing local scope to define a local or parameter. Yep, same thing. Okay. Okay. Right, so we're just adding this, and that means that whenever we call, so this should work with any Witling entering any cube like that. I'm sure I've got other errors everywhere. On Witling exit, this Witling. Sure. One more. And this is an anonymous delegate. Or not a delegate. Yeah, this is a lambda delegate, so it can never really be removed. Which is fine because it's pressure plate lock. Or is it fine? Maybe not. Consider so if I do give the users the ability to unlock the cube somehow, we won't be able to use a lambda here. Minor fix, nothing too crazy. Events, yeah. Huh, so this Witling turn, would slippery cubes kill you if you tried to walk off like this? I think so. Yeah, sure. Okay. That's not too terrible. So now we have this on Witling turn. And then in slippery. In start. On Witling enter cube. Death on turn. Oops. So we enter the cube, and then we tell a witling this is quite tricky. Well, let's just get the entering working. This is a private function, correct? Yes. No, Unity action. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh boy. Is there anything else we'll be doing besides on death when a witling turns? Well, I can't think of anything. So, I guess we could just change the signature of this delegate. Take a path node. And then we need to figure out where to call the onWitling turn. Awake, update, nope. Maybe in start pathing new face. Direction. So, let's make a new private function. This is going to be... This not equals is what got us into trouble with floats earlier. It's going to compare the X and Y and Z. In theory, it should be the same, but with floating point error, we want to... Is there a vector 3 near? No. I guess what I could do is dot them. And if it's less than, like, 0.9... Fine, you win. Door, vector 3 dot door. A much less commonly known mathematical operation. Well, let's just do a print turning. So here I should get 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. You have 5 turnings, right? Only 4. One, two, three. Two. Okay, so it turned here and here. Oh, start rotation does not equal target rotation. That's dangerous. Good grief. But it seems to be working for now. Aha! So yeah, it didn't work on the face transfer. One, two, collapse. Well, there were 4 turns. One from start pathing new face, awesome. And 3 from just the Witling movement. We should make a prefab of this cube spirit link. Oh, hey, this is the wrong one. Oh, no, it's not. Okay. Linked rotator none? What? What? Oh. Okay, it's there now. Whew. Good grief. Oh, right. Because the other one's not a prefab. Gotcha. So, let's make a new cube. Does it have a tint? Let's give it a tint. And this is going to be our slippery cube. To like an icy color, yeah. And then slippery. Oh, we are going to want the face container here. We do want it to change on start. Okay, so now we've got turning happening. So if the dot is whatever, not close to the same direction, and on Witling turn does not equal null, invoke death node is target node. Hey, cool. Okay, cool. So the exit isn't working yet, but I'm a little bit happier. I think we can finish this 5 minutes. We got 5 minutes. Okay. Slippery. So, core on Witling exit cube. I'm going to call this add. This is not really wonderful stuff. What don't you like about that? Plus, hey, there we go. Well, let's try it with this one. He should die. Okay. Let's rename this bad boy to our slippery cube. How's my naming convention? Am I going specific? Ugh, I'm not. I really should be. for sure. Lock cube. Hey, cool. So I like naming my stuff from specific to general. Like limited spin cube, that's a very specific version of the cube. So here we've got a slippery cube. Let's get a straight piece here. Yeah, buddy. Whoa! Oh, wait, that might be because of a multipath conflict here. Oh, no. Why? Oh. That might have been because he was walking this way. He turned. He entered this and then turned on the slippery cube and just died immediately. Interesting. Let's make sure that is what is happening, and if that is, I will be okay. Death on turn, Witling. Witling slipped and fell. Twice. Oh no, that's not actually what I want to happen. Because it entered the entered slippery cube, exited slippery cube, entered again. So it did enter the slippery cube. Let's make sure that this path node container, we've got our leaf node. Previous is branch node on the same one, so next is right end leaf node, which is on our pressure. Yep. Linked, that's correct. Okay, so they are linked. It was a turn that did our whittling in. Not sure how I feel about that. But, yeah, I'm pretty happy with what we got solved today. So, if you watched, thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.